Next, we will do a couple of examples where we will see a rigid body undergoing general planar motion. So the first example is 7.8, which is analysis of a falling rigid body. So in this problem, let me first draw this. So this problem, as part of a movie stunt, a long, thin, 388-pound platform, whose length is L equal to 39 feet, has been rigged across a ray vine using two ropes OA and BD. So we have a platform AB over here, and this platform AB is connected via two ropes, BD as well as OA. Okay, we know the length and the mass of this platform. So L is the length, was given to us, as well as its mass. Rope OA of length D equal to 13.4 feet. So OA has the length of D, so that's known as well. It's securely tied to the tree, but rope BD, this rope over here, has been tied to a carabiner at D that has not been adequately fastened to the rock face. After everything is set up, as shown in the figure, the carabiner at D breaks free. So right over here, the carabiner breaks free and the platform starts to fall. Determine the angular acceleration of the platform and the tension in the rope OA immediately after the rope BD breaks free. So things that we have to find are, one, the tension in the rope OA, so we'll call it TOA, and the angular acceleration of the platform. So that's alpha AB, let's say. Okay, and the initial value of theta. Theta is this angle also given to you, that's 39 degrees. So we'll just write theta over here. Okay, so the first thing to notice is that as soon as this rope BD over here is cut, the angular velocity of the whole system, the platform as well as the rope OA, is zero, right? So we know that as well. So angular velocity is zero because it has been just broken free. But that doesn't mean that angular acceleration of AB or OA would be zero either, right? So it's just the angular velocity that is zero at this instant. So what we'll do is we'll model OA as a rod of zero mass. So this will be treated as a massless rod essentially, right? And that means that we can assume that OA will be always in tension, so which means that immediately after BD is cut, the rope OA is not going to go slack. And you know, if you find that the tension in OA is positive, then that would confirm our assumption. All right, so how do we solve this problem? Well, let's first draw the coordinate system. So let's say this is x-axis, this is y-axis, okay? We have to do the kinematic analysis, that's the step number two. So goal of the kinematic analysis is to find the acceleration of the center of mass of AB, so we'll call this AG, okay, as well as the angular acceleration of the platform AB. Now, alpha AB is something that is asked for, right? So we don't know that. So what can we say about acceleration of center of mass? We can definitely relate the acceleration of center of mass with the acceleration of point A. We know something about the acceleration of point A. We can relate the acceleration of point A with the acceleration of point O, okay? And then in turn, relate acceleration of point G with the acceleration of A. So let's do that. So we'll do the kinematic analysis first. Kinematic analysis. So for OA, what do we have? We have acceleration of A equal to acceleration of O, which by the way would be zero because O is a fixed point, minus omega OA square R of A, which is O, which will also be zero because the angular velocities are zero. Everything started from rest, plus alpha OA K hat, which we don't know what it is, so we'll just assume that this is positive, alpha OA, counterclockwise, cross R of A with respect to O. Now, what is R? So, let me write alpha OA K hat cross R of A with respect to O is this vector, right? And this vector is D cosine theta minus J hat and D sine theta in positive I hat. So, let's write that. So, we have d sine theta I hat minus cosine theta j hat, right? So expression is positive, y direction is negative. So let's simplify this. We get d alpha OA sine theta k cross I is j, k cross j is negative I hat, so this is going to be plus cosine theta I hat. And that is the acceleration of A. Of course, everything is known over here with the exception of alpha OA. So we don't know that. That's fine. So we'll keep that as an unknown. Next, we can relate the acceleration of point G with respect to A, right? So let's do that as well. So acceleration of G, choosing A as a reference point, is this minus omega AB square times R of G with respect to O. And this is zero because the angular velocity at this instant is zero. Plus alpha AB k hat. Again, that's something we don't know, so we'll just assume it to be positive. Cross R of G with respect to A. So this is, let me substitute AA here, d alpha OA sine theta j hat plus cosine theta I hat plus alpha AB k cross R of G with respect to A is this vector, and that is L by 2 I hat. So that's L by 2 I hat. So we get d alpha OA, and I'm going to just simplify this. So k cross I is actually j, so we'll have d alpha OA sine theta plus alpha AB times L by 2, and that's j hat plus d alpha OA times cosine theta I hat. Okay, so that's what we get for the acceleration of center of mass. And you can clearly see that this is now expressed as a function of alpha OA, angular acceleration of rope OA, angular acceleration of the platform, and what else? And everything else is known, right? So D, L, and theta are known. So AG is expressed as a function of the angular acceleration of the rope and the platform. And we can also see that it has components along x direction as well as components along y direction. So this is all we can do as far as kinematic analysis is concerned. The next step is to draw a free body diagram. So let's draw a free body diagram of AB, the platform. So we have the weight, and then we have the tension, right? And this tension T is acting at an angle theta from vertical. So this angle is theta. And these are only forces because the rope BD has been already cut, so there's no tension coming from that, right? Now on this, we can apply Newton-Euler equations. So we have sigma F equal to M times acceleration of center of mass, and we have minus T sine theta I hat plus T cosine theta minus mg j hat, that's the forces, equal to M times acceleration of g, which we know from here. So let's call this equation 1, right? So we can substitute equation 1 in here, and that would give us two scalar equations. So let's write them. So by equating the coefficients of I hat on both sides, we get minus t sine theta equal to m times the x component is d alpha OA times cosine theta, and for the y component we'll get t cosine theta minus mg equal to m times the first term, which is d alpha OA sine theta plus alpha AB times L by 2, and that's it, right? So that's all we have. So that's your the second equation in the y direction for sigma f equal to ma. Okay, then we also have the second law of Newton-Euler, which is sigma mg equal to ig alpha. Now this is going to be applied on the platform AB. So this is platform AB, so alpha would be of the platform, so this would be ig times alpha AB. So let's take the moment about center of mass. No contribution from the gravity because it's passing through center of mass. Then we have a component t cosine theta which will contribute. So that'll be minus t cosine theta times L by 2 because that's clockwise equal to, and the Mass moment of inertia through the center of mass of a rod is given as m times L squared over 12 times alpha AB. Okay, so this is k hat, this is k hat, right? So what do we get? We get minus t cosine theta, and L cancels, this is 6, so that would be minus 6 t cosine theta over m times L equal to alpha AB. Okay, so this is the relationship between alpha AB and t, and we are interested in the t as well as alpha AB. So all we need is one more equation where we can substitute for it, and this looks like easy to do. So alpha O is not something that we want to know, so alpha O can be written from this equation into here, and that means that we will have one equation where we'll have t and alpha AB, and then this one, let's call it x, and this one called y, can be used to solve for both t and alpha AB, right? So if you compute the final numbers for both tension and alpha AB, the tension comes out to be 107.2 pound, which is actually a positive number, and that means that the tension in rope OA is positive, which means it's not going to go slack, and that was one of the assumptions that we had made before.